Hey guys, this is Rupesh from Beebom.com, and we all know that Oppo and OnePlus are sister companies that come right under BBK Electronics. And that means that every year, OnePlus flagships are kind of a tweaked version of one Oppo 4 on the other. Let me show you. The OnePlus 1, the Oppo Find 7a, OnePlus 3, Oppo R9 Plus, OnePlus 5, Oppo R11, OnePlus 5T, Oppo R11S, OnePlus 6, Oppo R15 Pro, the OnePlus 6T, Oppo R17, the OnePlus 7 Pro, the Oppo Reno 10X Zoom. Well, in 2020, OnePlus 8 Pro, the Oppo Find X2 Pro, well, maybe. So what are you waiting for? This is the Oppo Find X2 Pro, and this is what maybe the OnePlus 8 Pro looks like. So let's take a look. Okay, so according to the leaks and rumors, the OnePlus 8 Pro will bring upgrades to design, the display, cameras, battery, and charging. So let's take it one by one. On the design front, the OnePlus 8 Pro is rumored to be fixing the biggest issue everyone had with the OnePlus 7 Pro and 7T Pro, the big form factor. Well, take a look at the Oppo Find X2 Pro. It looks like the OnePlus 7T Pro, and while it isn't exactly compact, it's slightly narrower, which makes holding it easier. Here are the dimensions of the Find X2 Pro and the OnePlus 7T Pro side by side, and you can notice the width, right? Yeah, that's what makes the difference. Now, apart from this, the back of the Find X2 Pro is gorgeous, especially this vegan leather finish. But obviously, this won't make it in the OnePlus 8 Pro. But yeah, there's one thing that I'm hoping makes it, the IP68 rating. Yeah, the Find X2 Pro has the IP68 rating, and with rumors suggesting that the OnePlus flagships will finally bring an IP rating, this makes me all hopeful. Having said that, the Oppo Find X2 Pro does not have wireless charging, and the OnePlus flagships are rumored to be bringing that, so I'm hoping OnePlus does not skip on that. Moving on to the display of the Find X2 Pro, and that's something that should be identical in the OnePlus 8 Pro. This is a beautiful curved 6.7-inch QHD Plus AMOLED display with a 120Hz refresh rate and Gorilla Glass 6. Yep, top of the line, and this looks gorgeous. Honestly, I'm not a fan of the OnePlus 7 Pro, but I love its big bold display. Now, this display on the Find X2 Pro looks like it can do justice to the OnePlus 8 Pro. It just looks so good. I mean, yeah, if you've noticed, there's no pop-up camera, there's a punch hole, but I don't think it makes a huge negative impact, at least not me. Apart from that, OnePlus has already confirmed the 120Hz refresh rate, so I think this might be the same display that will be used in the OnePlus 8 Pro. Now, if you're wondering about the experience, well, this display here feels super silky to the touch. It's just really nice, especially when you're scrolling. Plus, it has some interesting features. There's automatic white balance adjustment based on ambient lighting, and the phone has an Ultra Vision engine, which brings two things: SDR to HDR video conversion and motion interpolation. First, converts usual videos to HDR friendly videos, and second, makes videos smoother by bumping up the frame rate from 30 to 60 or even 120 FPS to look even better on this 120Hz panel. Now, both of these features are supported in apps like Netflix, YouTube, Prime Video, but when I did try it out, it did work for me on Netflix and Prime, although in YouTube, I did not notice a difference here. Either ways, this is really cool, and yeah, this has to be one of the most beautiful smartphone displays out there. So if the OnePlus 8 Pro does bring in this display, I'd be more than glad. Next up, another big change I'm expecting from the OnePlus 8 Pro is on the camera front. Honestly, when it comes to cameras, the OnePlus flagships have always failed to impress. But if the Find X2 Pro is any indication, things might be a little different this time. Just take a look at the specs. So the Find X2 Pro comes with a 48 megapixel f1.7 primary camera with OIS, and this is not your old 48 megapixel sensor. This is Sony's new IMX689 sensor. This is Sony's new on-chip lens solution, and it's said to bring improved focus, a 1x1.43 inches large sensor, a big pixel size of 2.24 microns, post-pixel binning, for better low-light shots. Well, the other cameras are exciting too. There's a 48 megapixel ultra wide angle camera, and well, this should mean better, more detailed ultra wide angle shots, something that's missing in current ultra wide sensors. Last but definitely not the least, there's a 13 megapixel periscope telephoto lens with OIS, and it's capable of 10x hybrid zoom and insane 60x digital zoom. Yeah, these specs sound promising. Now, in my brief time with the phone, I have noticed that the new IMX689 sensor does capture some really good shots. There's a lot of detail, and I like the accurate colors. Now, these are daytime shots, but where the Find X2 Pro has impressed me are low light shots. In the few low light shots I've taken, they look very detailed and sharp. And honestly, so far, I think these are flagship grade smartphone photos. That's not all, the 48 megapixel ultra wide angle camera here is also pretty cool. Check out some shots. Now, the best thing about this is that we finally have very detailed ultra wide angle shots compared to the main camera shots. Yep, let's just zoom in on this photo. And look at the detail, it's very impressive. And I like the fact that this ultra-wide-angle lens can capture fairly nice low-light ultra-wide shots too. I mean, it's not perfect, but these are some of the best ultra-wide-angle shots I have seen. There's also the 60x capable periscope camera on board, and well, here's it in action. Here's a 1x shot, here's a 5x shot now, which looks very sharp and nice. Now here's a 10x zoom shot, which isn't as sharp, but it's still pretty good. Now here's the 60x zoom shot, which obviously is not very sharp, but it's still fairly good. So overall, these cameras make up for some really good photos. Even the video quality is pretty good. Here's a 4K 60fps video, which looks very detailed and very sharp. The phone also has dual OIS, so the video is fairly stable too. Well, to be honest, I haven't exactly reviewed the Find X2 Pro's cameras extensively, but from the looks of it, this looks really good. And yeah, OnePlus, please bring us this camera setup. Now the display and the cameras are obviously the highlight, but the Find X2 Pro brings top of the line crazy specs too. You get the Snapdragon 865 chipset, 12GB RAM, 512GB UFS 3.0 storage, a 32 megapixel selfie camera, a fairly big 4260mAh battery with super insane 65 watt charging. Now the flagship specs are pretty much a surety with the OnePlus 8 Pro as well. But on the charging front, it's set to be coming with a 50 watt dash charger, and there'll obviously be Oxygen OS on board. Anyway, look, the OnePlus 7T Pro, well, that was a big disappointment. But if the OnePlus 8 Pro is close to this, the Find X2 Pro, well, that is going to be really awesome. I mean, a premium design, the 120Hz AMOLED with punch hole, the top of the line specs are pretty much expected in the OnePlus 8 Pro, so it's all about the cameras. I just hope that OnePlus does not make any compromises on the camera front, because that's the only area where the OnePlus flagships do not feel flagship-like. Overall, the Find X2 Pro seems like a great flagship phone, but if it is truly the OnePlus 8 Pro, well, it's going to be super exciting. Well, what do you think of the Oppo Find X2 Pro, and do you like it if you think about it as the OnePlus 8 Pro? Tell us in the comment section below. Also, give this video a thumbs up if you enjoyed it, and make sure to share it with your friends. Lastly, subscribe to our channel for more amazing tech videos. Well, that's me signing off. Thanks for watching, and I will see you in the next one.